Rubric Marines are undying warriors that were once psychers before an ancient curse damned them to an eternity as living husks. In this video, we're going to show how to paint one of these models. We're going to paint them in the classic method and up to battle ready. But the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Retributor armor, which is perfect for the colors we're going to be using in this video. Now we're going to start by picking out the armor. For this, we'll be using the aptly named Thousand Suns Blue. So first of all, I'm going to get my small layer brush. Just going to apply a little bit to the palette. Not want it too thick and goopy, so I'm just going to add a little bit of water to it. Try and keep a nice point, and then we're ready to start base coating. Now all you need to do is start picking out the armor panels. You might want to do a couple of thin coats over here. Now if you're unsure as to where to paint blue, just check your box art for details. And there we are, with all the blue armor now picked out and any gold areas tidy back up, we're going to move on to applying the rest of the base coats. Now I'm going to start by using a Baden black for any black details. This is things like the gun casing and his armor joints. After that, we're going to move on to the silver details. For this, we'll be using Lead Belcher. Then we'll use Celestial Grey for his white tabard, Avalanche Sunset for any yellow details, and finally we'll pick his eyes out using Corax White. But first of all, let's start with that black. So I'm just going to apply a little bit of a Baden black to the palette like so, a little touch of water, and we're ready to start base coating. So like I said, there's only a couple of areas to worry about on there. So that's his gun casing, which is just around here, and any armour joins around the back of his knees and also his elbow joins. Those black areas now picked out, we're going to move on to applying the silver. So for this we'll be using Lead Belcher. So on the bolt gun there's a few working parts to pick out, as well as the actual muzzle. And then on his backpack he's got a few areas to pick out as well. With the silver details now picked out, we're going to move on to paint the tabard using Celestial Grey. Okay, and you probably want to do a couple of thin coats of this as well. There we are, with the tabard now done, we're going to move on to picking out the yellow details, and for this we're using Avalanche Sunset. So it's mainly on the crown here, and you want to do every other stripe. There's also some on his wrist and at the back of the crown as well. Now that we've done those yellow details, the last thing to do is just pick out his eyes using Corax White. So obviously you've got his lenses on his face to do. There's a couple of eyes scattered across the model as well. There's one just on his chest, one on his crown, some on his knees, and of course there's one on his backpack as well. Just take your time, and if you do make any mistakes, just tidy back up with the paints that are around it. There we are, with all the base coats now applied, we're going to move on to applying some shades. Now we're going to start by using Norn Oil. We're going to coat this all over the model. Then for the eyes, we're just going to pick those out using a little bit of Biltan Green. But first of all, let's start with that Norn Oil. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette, just so I don't heavily overload the brush. I'm using a medium shade brush for this as well, just because I can get a little bit more on there. And all we're then going to do is just start applying that all over the armour, as well as the gold. Don't forget to pick out any other details. Now you will probably find you might get a little bit of the Norn Oil onto the white, so just tidy back up with Corax White when you've done. Now that the Norn Oil's dry, we're going to move on to applying a Biltan Green to the eyes. Now that all the shades are dry, we're going to move on to applying some texture to the base. Now for this we'll be using Valhalla Blizzard. I'm going to be using my trusty texture tool. We'll start with the large side first, just scoops him out like so, and all we'll then do is then dollop that onto the base like so. Now there's a smaller side, so I'm just going to move around to that for a little bit more accuracy, especially around those feet. Now you want to leave this for around about an hour to dry, and once it's dry you can then paint the rim of the base in the colour that matches your army. For this one we're going to be using Steel Legion Drab. There we are, with the texture now dry and the rim of the base painted, our Rubric Marine is now battle ready. Now there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when using base paint, try and be as neat as you can. Remember, the neater you are, the better the end result. And when using shades, try not to overload your brush with too much shade, as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find this happening, just use your brush to soak up any excess. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own battle-ready Rubric Marines, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.